So good morning, everybody. So Patrick just gave a nice overview of what's going on, and I'm going to go a little further into what the platform has to offer. And like you heard Jack said, it's all about you. And really what I'm going to share here today with you is what we're doing, how we're basically creating useful technology to support you in what you do. You are our users, and it's very much focused around ArcGIS. But it's important to understand that we don't just do this. We actually get that information from you, from conferences, when we work with you, when you use our software, you report back to us, and when we train you. So what we then do is we take all this information and we look at it, and then we decide what to do. And we have thousands of employees that then take this information, puts it into development, testing, training, and services. And then in a collaborative effort, they convert what you want to do into some of the things that I'm going to show you now. GIS or ArcGIS is an integrated platform. It's a complete platform, like Patrick mentioned, for managing your spatial information. And one of the key things here is that it's a very open platform and it's service-based. So it's not just an application, it's a platform that lives on services. So you can build services that can be consumed by other services or by other live applications. And the thing about this is that it's available both on your machine and on your devices. It's available in the cloud. And the whole intention doing it this way is basically to support you, either as a person, small business, or an entire organization. So we want to have the flexibility and scalability to support you in any way we can. And we do this through multiple implementation patterns. So we can either do it on the desktop, we can do it on a server, we can do it in an enterprise system, and we can do it distributed, we can do it in the cloud. And the most exciting thing about all this is that it's not an either or. We can do everything at once. So we can fit any purpose. And that to me, you know, and I've implemented big systems in Esri over the last, I would say, 16 years. So this whole development is just so exciting. We can literally go in everywhere and support anybody's need right now. And budget, I would say. But the thing is that in the cloud, which is one of the new things that we're moving into, we're also starting to look at how can we support just infrastructure. You might not have the IT, so you want to put your infrastructure in the cloud. Well, you might say, well, I don't have the IT personnel, so I will also put the software as a service in the cloud. Or you say, well, I really don't care about all this. I just want to have the platform and go on doing my job. So we can put the platform on the service in the cloud. So this plethora of implementation patterns really suits almost any type of need that you might have. And then with ArcGIS, we manage all aspects of what you do. So it's not just about data or analysis. It could be, you know, your workflows. It could be your data, metadata. It could be all your maps. It could be the users, you know, who has access to what data. We could support the build-up of models. And the whole thing can be distributed through Portal, which really is available to give different access, different people, different access to different data. What we also do is that we're advancing the ArcGIS capabilities. And what I'd like to do is I'll walk through some of these new things that we've been doing over the last year. And Patrick, again, alluded a little bit to what it was, but I really want to give you the whole picture here. One of the big things is the data, so it's the content that we have in there. So we have this ArcGIS, but we really want to have content in there. And one of the things that we have is that we have RTA online. So if you, of course, have licenses, paid licenses, then you have free access to this. And what we worked on here is that we worked on just putting a lot of ready, available data set up there that is free of charge that you can use. For example, we have different road networks, traffic intensity, and so forth. So there's a ton of information that you simply just can grab in, put up as base map, when you work with the GIS, whether you're working on a device or you're working on a desktop. But above that, there is the whole community, our community, all our users. What they do is that they continuously upload data from all parts of the world within all sectors. And that data can be available as well that you can use and consume. So you're really starting to share data. And that's what we call open data. So it's probably the biggest collection of geographic information that you can find in the world that we have in RTS Online. So there's, again, a wealth of information that we can do. We're doing a lot of work on data management and compilation, so we're really advancing our data models. And a new one that's come up is a new utility network model. But we're also supporting data management, you know, with improved data editing tools. One of the things that we are supporting now is stereo feature extraction, and I know that a lot of mapping agencies are very interested in this particular thing, that can be integrated into the platform and our map production line. And of course, we have a closer integration with CAD tools. We're building an even tighter collaboration, so it almost is like, you know, whether you're working in one environment or the other, it really doesn't matter for us. But more importantly, we're continuing to expand into the field because we want you to be able to work anywhere, anytime. So one of the things we've done is that we've expanded a little bit on our foundational applications, like the workforce, which organizes your work, and Survey123, where you can set surveys up, you can collect field data, or the data collector, you go out and you literally can collect data from the field, whether it's an area. I showed some of that in yesterday's presentation in land administration, where you literally go out and do a general boundary survey, just walking around the perimeter. And the thing here is that everything is connected, so it gets feedback into the central database real time if you're connected. So somebody can sit in the office, use Workforce, and say, hey, you need to go over there and interview, do a job, do a field inspection. It could be a pipe, whatever it is. It literally pops up on this one because you have Workforce in this one. You go out, you open your navigator, you navigate to it, and then you do your inspection using Collector or Survey123. You say submit, and boom, right away it's back in the office, and everybody can see it and work on it. But one of the cool things, and I think this is, you know, been a continuous challenge for us, but we're getting there. But it's been the disconnected editing environment. So especially our data collector, and with the new map services, allows us to cache data and be disconnected in the field, do the updates, and as soon as you're connected, that it goes back to the general system again, to the enterprise system. But what it allows you to do is really to go in and organize all your field workers and coordinate their work. And you can track that as you they do their work. Within mapping and cartography, we're really advancing a lot of tools and methods. So one of the things we're doing is that we're doing more smart mapping. We're bringing more tools into 2D and 3D. And we're working on something we call very fast mapping. And very fast mapping means that we can show a lot of features very fast and almost dynamically. Up in the upper right corner, you'll see production charting and mapping. And that is our map production toolkit. And one of the things we're working on there, especially, and I can say to our colleagues from Ethiopia, that this was Ethiopia that drove this particular development, because they have a need to support their 1 to 10K production map or topographic mapping. So what we're doing right now is that we've taken our 1 to 25K civilian topographic map our civilian topographic model, and we're moving it down to 1 to 10K, so they can use that. So that's definitely a huge enhancement. If we look at vector plots to speed up display, both in 2D and 3D, we actually have developed that, and you can see it running here. And what we've also done is that we've built a projection engine. So not only do you need to if you have a data in standard projection, that's fine, but you can do it in your own projection and bring it in there as well. So this is a really cool thing. If we look at 3D, we've improved capabilities across the platform. We've provided much more stronger tools for visualization. We have incorporated some of the 3D capabilities into our urban planning and design tools. And again, these are extensions that's just out of the box that you can work with as a part of your planning. We've added new 3D data types and meshes, so we support 3D objects and 3D meshes. And down in the innovation area, we're really starting to look into, and that's something we're working on right now, is animatronics. You know, how can you actually do this on the fly, as you can see? We're working in virtual reality and augmented reality. We really haven't released anything, but it's something that we're looking heavily into. If we look at RTIS, we're also, as an imagery platform, we're also really doing a lot of work, or been doing a lot of work, because we support basically all sensors now. We can take data from big satellites, small satellites, air photos, multi-dimensional data. And we also support dynamic image processing, which means that you do image processing on the fly. And I'm not quite sure that you might fully understand what this is about, but it is really, in the old days you'll get a raw image and you'll have to process that raw image, and it'll take maybe some hours, and then you can start to take a look at it. That's not happening now. You take the raw image and you do it right away. So you can really do on-the-fly results. You can do types of analysis on-the-fly. You don't have to process the data. So this is again a huge thing to speed up processes. Spatial analysis. We're really moving more analytical tools into our world and making them more available. Remember, Patrick was talking about three systems. This really relates to system of insight, that you take the data you have, the data that is on RTIS, online, you merge it together, and you start to work with it using spatial analytics. One of the things we've done to really speed up the process is there's something in called a GPU. So we're really starting to take advantage of the very fast processing that the GPU is capable of. So we're moving some of the analysis, both raster and partly vector, into the GPU component to speed up the processes. And those of you who both work with raster data or grids, and let's say we have a country like the size of Tanzania, will absolutely know what I'm talking about here. So this is one of the big things that we're starting to take advantage of. The other thing I want to highlight here very quickly is that we have Model Builder. We've had Model Builder for many years, but what we can do now is that we can actually take any model and set it up as a service. So what does that mean? That means that if you have certain types of analysis that you want to share, you can put it on your RTIS server, put it up as a service, and then everybody else can consume it. You can even put it in RTIS Online, maybe in your own group, and everybody can consume that. So you can start to share your model, your analysis. And again, this is a huge thing. Insights is a product that actually supports some of this, the spatial analysis. And it's a new product that came out earlier this year. And what it does is that it allows you to take your data, use out-of-the-box tools, and start to do exploitative data analysis. And there are different tools that you can use to do that. Big data analysis, we have been working on it. What we're doing is that we're expanding it further. We're now building we're building algorithms that will allow us to do much, much faster processing of data. So we're talking about that we can handle tens of millions of observations order per second and analyze that. So we're really getting ready to handle this whole area of big data. And the same goes, the same technology we can use on the raster side, where we now can take thousands of images and almost instantly do analysis across these images. One of the things that's important about big data and goes beyond that is this real-time analytics that we're building. We basically integrate into sensor networks and the Internet of Things. And that's things that comes forward, you know. So you have all these command operation rooms within different sectors, and they start to be more and more dependent on different sensors and devices to extract information and give a real-time situational awareness of what's going on. So one of the things we can do now is that we can basically take millions, like I said before, of observations per second and analyze those real time, so you get these pictures, what's going on. And of course, if you have certain event, we have something called geo event processor. If you have certain events, you can set that up and you can monitor and follow these types of event inside your situation room. And again, to help you to be very productive out of the box, we have this whole concept of COTS first, customization second. So over the last few years, Esri has fully turned on this. So we really want to enable you right away. So when you are working with the ArcGIS platform, you're not kind of left out in the dark. Very quick story. Many years ago, I got a silicon graphic when I was working at the Agricultural University in Copenhagen. And we paid heaps of dollars for that machine. And at that time, Esri gracefully gave us a free license. And all my colleagues came up and they said, what can this GIS do? And this was back in the old days with our GIS workstation. And the only thing I could show them was a little command window that said arc with a colon. And then I had about 6,000 commands I needed, but I literally couldn't do anything. It took me several months to do good presentations and demonstrations, get the data ready and so forth, and analysis. You can do that in less than an hour today. Set it up, build applications, use out-of-the-box applications like what you see here. For example, for geo design, to build location intelligence, and domain-specific applications like the roads and highways, you can basically load data and there it is, you can be productive right away. And that's the whole key in the Esri approach, is to get you up and running very fast and very efficiently, so you become successful very quickly in what you do. One of the things that we really been working hard on, and we always, it's kind of a stigma, and it's about definition. So what does it mean to be open? Well, the platform is absolutely open. It can integrate into almost anything. And trust me, I've done this for 16 years. But what we do is that we have a lot of open data standards and formats. So of course we follow ODC. We also follow ISO. And a lot of other things. I myself am actually in several ISO committees working on addressing standards. So we're really very active in this area to make sure that we're in alignment with the thinking of the best minds in the world. We also do direct product integration, which means that we integrate into existing products. You don't have to write the handshakes, the protocols, or anything. We've already done it for you. It's right there out of the box. And then, of course, we have open software. So this whole, all the APIs that we have in Esri, you can access directly. And if you need sample code, you can just go to GitHub. There's a huge community in GitHub that shares and exchange information that you can use. So we're really moving very fast ahead, and we're not stopping, because a big part of what Esri does, a big part of what we actually earn, goes into doing what you have asked us to do. Research it, make sure that it works. So once we release it, that you can become successful. And some of the things we're looking at right now is more 3D, smart mapping, make it easier to map. We're looking at artificial intelligence, to use analytics to create insight, scientific modeling, very fast display, because we're going to see, like Patrick said, we get more and more connected. And one of the things that I just want to say here is that there's really, with the way that the technology is today, a chance for you to leapfrog forward. So taking advantage of the whole ESRI technology. So with that, I will hand it over to my colleague from ESRI. Thank you.